Blog Talk Radio.
To the 14th day of January 2015, 8 a.m. Eastern here at Blog Talk Radio. Perspective Power is the network, and we do appreciate the fact that you find us and follow us and share us and give people the information, the 411 as they call it. Find us at blogtalkradio.com/perspective power. We also are grateful for the wonderful music of award-winning composer David Martinko. Find his music at redbellymusic.com and sunshadows.net. You'll find lots of great music to download there for free, as well as the wonderful CDs that he has available, so enjoy. It's great. And we are so happy that you are here and enjoying the program today. It is amazing that we get a chance to connect the way we do here. Why? Because it is amazing. And I think a lot of people don't realize the power behind hearing somebody else talk to them. I mean, a lot of times we hear the voices that we use to speak to ourselves, and they are important, but sometimes it helps to hear somebody else say them so that we understand their full impact and we realize that these voices, these words, I was going to say the voices that we use to talk to ourselves, to speak to ourselves, really do, they mean a lot, but they are affected is what I meant to say. They are affected by what and how other people speak to us. The topic today is affirmations for loving ourselves. And in many cases, when we're born, and I can't say in every case because I don't believe we can be that general, but in many cases when we're born, love is just a natural happenstance. Our families love us. They're grateful we're here. The world surrounds us with love. I mean, heavens, we're newborn babies. We have all the potential in the world for life to be great, for life to be beautiful, for life to be enjoyable. So if we go on the premise that when we're born, the love is all there and all we have to do is just lay there and accept it, it seems to make sense. Then as we get older and we start to put meaning behind and ownership and take ownership of the words that are said to us, somehow that word love becomes a bit compromised. And it isn't necessarily intentional. In some cases, it can be. So when somebody says something that is less than loving or kind to us, if it is said often and with energy that makes it seem urgent and important, then we are going to tend to believe that. So we want to make sure that we remember that it's the energy behind the words that makes all the sense. This is what makes affirmations powerful. This is what makes them work, is the energy behind the words, and then the feeling that we get from that energy, which is what brings it into us and allows us to take ownership of it. And again, it's the frequency with which the specific words are said or the feelings that we get from the different words that are said. So the feeling here is the key. Once we feel it, then we can bring it about. Once we feel it, then we can claim the ownership. And the more frequently we feel a certain way about something, in this case the word love, and loving ourselves, directing it, then we will notice that this comes to play in our actual lives. So it may sound a bit complicated, but really it's not. It's just that when we're little, when we're teeny tiny and we're new, we're not sitting there trying to figure it out. And fortunately or unfortunately, we all grow up differently. And as a result, some of us grow up having that energy frequently. The feelings are supported and nurtured. And we grow up loving ourselves. And you can tell there are people out there that have grown up loving themselves because you can watch what they do, watch their choices in life, watch how they handle the scenarios and the situations that occur. Because not every single day is roses and you know, champagne. Sometimes the champagne's flat, and sometimes the roses are a little brown because they've been in the sun too long, or it's just their time to become compost in the flower bed. The idea here is, how do those people handle that? How do those people get through those times, those seemingly trying times? Because they love themselves enough to honor. And I want to talk about the word love for a second. I want to define that. Because love is anything that falls under the umbrella of the word love. It's caring, appreciation, kindness, respect, honesty, happiness, health, peace, joy, trust, value, honor. Now, I just gave you a few words. I gave you a few things to think about when we think about love. If it isn't sounding like these words, a word you're using to describe your life, your body, your bank account, your work, your relationships, if it isn't a word that sounds like those words I just gave you, that's not love. That's fear. And if you're operating in words that fall under the category of fear, then you are going to find it more difficult to accept an affirmation to love yourself simply because you're living with a different umbrella. We're going to change the umbrella, and we're going to give ourselves the opportunity to be in love with ourselves, to show ourselves love, to be as kind to ourselves as we would to somebody else. Because that's the easy thing, too. When you say to somebody else, I love you, when you say to somebody else, I care for you, I appreciate what you do, and you show them that honor and that kindness, it's easier to do because we feel when we say these things and we share them with other people that we are showing them something that is good for them. We're giving them a chance to believe in themselves. We're maybe helping them over a rough time in their life, and we want to be helpful and useful. It makes us feel good to do that. That good feeling that we get is the feeling that we are seeking when we love ourselves. So why is it so difficult to look in the mirror and say those things to us? You did a good job today. You're amazing. Why is it difficult? Because somewhere inside of ourselves, we have this little voice that says, no, you didn't. You didn't do a good job at all. You sloughed off. You took too long. It didn't turn out the way you thought it was going to. You didn't do a good job at all. And somewhere inside of ourselves, if we look in the mirror and we say, you are amazing, this little voice might kick in and say, yeah, amazing, all right. I'm amazed you're still around, or I'm amazed anybody likes you. Again, those voices come from something we heard frequently, we took ownership of, we feel we deserve it, and we've given it our energy. When we look at affirmations for loving ourselves, we can be grateful for the fact that this knowledge of what is happening in our life that is fear-related is actually a good sign. If we learned how to do that, we can learn how to do this. So you could even be grateful that you learned how to own those voices that come back to you. And many people say, oh, that was my significant other that told me that. That was a schoolmate that told me that. That was one of my relatives that told me that. One of my parents that told me that. Siblings that told me that. Whomever. It doesn't matter. But the good news is, if you learned how to own those, you can learn how to own these. And I'm going to start with allowing, because I think that's the big key here with affirmations, especially loving affirmations. We don't allow ourselves to do it. And why? Back the program up a little bit and listen to what I just said, because with frequency, we've taken ownership of the feelings and the energy that have come to us because we've allowed it to happen. If you can allow that, you can allow this. So I'm going to give you some affirmations for loving yourself here that seem very simple, and they also seem incredibly simplistic. There is a reason for that. We're starting to learn to do this. You know, this is the beginning of 2015. And it's a year of really giving ourselves the chance that we deserve. It's the year of really giving ourselves the opportunity to move forward. Opportunity's huge here. So let's start and move with it. Let's start by saying, I allow myself to be happy. I allow myself to be happy. I allow myself to be happy. That's pretty powerful. You can look in the mirror and say that to your eyes. I allow myself to be happy. I allow myself to be happy. How about, this is a huge one now, especially after the holidays. I allow myself to eat healthy. I allow myself to eat healthy. I allow myself to eat healthy. Now, why do you think you would need to say that? So many times, we'll make the choice between this thing that we think we want and this thing that we think we want, but when we look at the results we get, we say to ourselves, oh, why did I eat that when I know I should have eaten this? Let's not should on ourselves. Let's just allow ourselves to eat healthy. I allow myself to appreciate myself. Another big one. I allow myself to appreciate myself. I allow myself to appreciate myself. You can say that with conviction. You can say that with certainty. You can say that with courage. I allow myself to value my talents. I allow myself to value my talents. I allow myself to value my talents. A lot of people are looking for better work. A lot of people want more money. Well, if you're not valuing your talents, you're always going to question whether or not you found the right job, whether or not it is doing something for you, whether or not you even should go out and look. There's that should again. If you are valuing your talents, you will draw to you that which will honor those talents. And that brings up the very next affirmation for loving ourselves. I honor my needs. I honor my needs. I honor my needs. Needs can be spiritual, physical, mental, or emotional. Needs can be financial. Needs can be food, sustenance. Needs can be just the time to be alone. I honor my needs. And speaking of time, I respect my time. I respect my time. I respect my time. Why would you use that necessarily? Well, to say I respect my time means that if you find that you're in a situation that seems to be frittering away your time and not honoring it or respecting it, you have the right to disengage from that scenario, from that situation. That could be a project you're working on. That could be spending your time in an environment that isn't healthy for you. If you respect your time, you realize how precious it is and how you only have so many hours in the day and so many days in the week, and you want to increase your efficiency in your world, what you get out, give out, what you get back. When you say to yourself, I respect my time, and you say it frequently, you take ownership of it by feeling good about this, and you own and use and display that energy, you will find yourself making all the choices that are necessary to show that you respect your time, honor your needs, value your talents, appreciate yourself, eat healthy, and be happy. And the affirmations for loving ourselves become absolutely wonderfully visible. They become great tools. They become our friends. Because when we love ourselves, we are being a friend to ourselves. Now, we're going to be covering more affirmations about loving ourselves here in the rest of the month of January. It's become such an important thing that I've noticed with other people that I'm compelled to invite you to return to Attitude of Gratitude every Wednesday morning at 8 a.m. Eastern here at blogtalkradio.com/perspective power, blogtalkradio.com, in case that got cut off there. And return and enjoy learning more about affirmations for loving ourselves here on Attitude of Gratitude, because it is so important that we love ourselves. It is so important that we take time for ourselves. It's important that we honor the contributions of those in our lives that have been so helpful, such as we are asking you to honor and support award-winning artist David Martinko. Find his music at redbellymusic.com and sunshadows.net, and thank him and support him. Find me, Annette Rochelle Aben, all over social media. We'll put up links so that you can connect and stay connected. We are honored that you do so, and we are always honored to support the joy and the beauty and the fun of affirmations for loving yourself here on An Attitude of Gratitude.